On behalf of Vistex, the global leader in go-to-market solutions, I am Ron Roscoe, and with me today is Matt Brown, a business advisor with Vistex. Today, we are going to discuss the competitive landscape of wholesale distribution and ways in which distributors are maximizing their profitability. Welcome, Matt.
Thank you, Ron.
So when we talk about wholesale distribution, we're talking about a very large and very complex, we're going to hear complex a lot in our conversation today, an industry that has a lot of competition. My first question to you is, how do wholesale distributors maintain and thrive in such a competitive work environment?
Yeah, that's a really good point, Ron. It's a very large industry. In fact, it's over almost $6 trillion in gross revenue annually in just the U.S. alone. You know, it's divided across nearly two dozen major sectors. And of course, you know, within that, there's a lot of complex arrangements that are needed really to bring those goods and services to consumers. And distributors must be good at navigating that ever-changing relationship with their manufacturers and customers so they can remain profitable. So in order for a distributor to grow, they must build and maintain strong relationships between their suppliers, their salespeople, and their customers. So all three of those really need to work well together and be enabled with good tools and good information in order to be profitable.
Okay, so speaking of profitability and seeing the numbers, how do distributors optimize their gross to net income?
Yeah, so, you know, when you're talking about gross to net income, you're really talking about, you know, maximizing your revenue and reducing your operating costs and expenses. So, you know, distributors, much like any business, they need to not only operate very efficiently to reduce those expenses, but they also have to maximize their revenue by not missing out on lost sales opportunities and reducing gross margin leakage. So first, you know, we look at how distributors can reduce their operating costs by providing their employees with the tools and the systems that are robust, flexible, and most of all, easy to use. You know, for example, a pricing tool that allows vendor prices to be loaded quickly, or tools that allow sellers to quickly and accurately analyze the best sales channels for their products. So, you know, next thing we can look at, distributors need to be very adept at managing their vendor and customer programs in order to charge back money that they're entitled to.
Okay, so let's shift gears. Let's talk about vendor rebate programs and why they are so important to distributors' bottom line and seeing what really works.
Yeah, so many distributors, you know, buy at negotiated prices for the manufacturer, and they set up these agreements with the manufacturer so they can adjust their pricing later based on various, you know, market conditions. And, you know, this is very effective as an arrangement, especially when it's more efficient to buy in bulk from a manufacturer when the future economic conditions are unknown. This allows the manufacturers and distributors the opportunity to negotiate and adjust pricing for a variety of reasons, such as reacting to competition or adjusting seasonal inventory levels. So both purchase and sales programs can vary greatly, such as exchange of marketing funds to help advertising and promoting of certain products. It could be volume purchase incentives, price protections, and growth rebates, just to name a few.
Okay, so we've talked about this before, and I've heard it come up me twice, and you've said it, the complexity. We talk about how complex this can be. What do distributors, what can they do to avoid leaving money on the table?
Well, yeah, they can be very complex, and unfortunately, distributors do leave money on the table. Oftentimes, it can be the difference between making a profit or a loss that quarter. And, you know, while vendors attempt to claim back as much money as they can, you know, there's often calculation errors, they have disputes, and there's delays. So many times, information is coming in from just a variety of sources and being poorly managed, whether it's in spreadsheets or even, you know, outdated software systems. So in order for them to remain competitive, they really need to manage their vendor programs both efficiently and accurately so they just don't leave any money on the table.
Okay, so they've got to react quickly to market changes. How do they do that though? I mean, that's easier said than done.
Yeah, I guess, you know, simply put, in order for them to maximize that cost recovery, distributors really have to have software that allows enormous amount of flexibility so they can manage these programs. I mean, more than that, they really must be able to adapt quickly. So remember, Ron, some of these programs can be very complex, very multidimensional business rules that need to be changed at a moment's notice. The software simply can't be the limiting factor. You know, it really needs to be a business enabler. So in order to recover the maximum amount of money, distributors need the proper tools in place to to manage their agreements, their chargebacks, their rebates, their accruals, you know, their reconciliations and their settlements. It's really a double-edged sword. The more integrated, streamlined, and automated those tools are, not only will they bring in more revenue, but they will reduce the operating costs by improving operating efficiency. It all adds up.
Okay. Source data. We talked about data is king, and that's all you hear about is data. Source data for these programs, how does it impact the distributor's profitability?
Distributors have so much and, you know, so many multiple sources of data coming in, whether it's reseller sales data, purchase orders, stock levels, customer invoices, you know, all those things. And they could all be inputs into an incentive program calculation. So it's very cumbersome usually to aggregate and track all that information and claim back money without the proper software tools in place.
We've talked a lot about the importance of being flexible and efficient, you know, in software tools. How can a distributor see what to do next and gain better visibility into how and where they should be selling their products?
Yeah, and good point. You know, a distributor can have the best software to manage and operate purchase and sales programs, you know, track claims, but it's not going to be as useful if they can't make sense of those mountains of data that's at their disposal. So, you know, that's really kind of where insights and analytics capabilities come into play. So for example, you need to be able to forecast your gross to net profitability. You need to be able to simulate that effect of, you know, the various business rules that they're going to have on your margins. And you also need to have visibility into sales channels or segments or product groupings that help increase your sales margins. It's also important that your channel partners, your retailers, your resellers also have that visibility to pricing changes through proper notifications and even price catalogs.
I'm going to put my distributor hat on here for a second, Matt. I'm trying to remain competitive, but I've got outdated system, or it's inadequate, it's outdated. What are going to be my first steps to try to get back to being competitive or thriving?
Yeah, good point. You know, the bottom line is you really need to start by taking a holistic look at your overall business operations and making strategic technology investment decisions from there. So you have to ask yourself, you know, how well are your business operations integrated and how well are your systems enabling and really streamlining those operations? You know, do your purchasing managers have all the tools they need to do their jobs effectively? Are you making use of your data to gain insights into your channels, your segments, so that you can optimize that profitability? I mean, having the right system in place not only empowers you to make more informed decisions about what inventory to stock and how much, but also what value proposition resonates with each of those customer segments and what prices to charge, you know, and ultimately which channels and customers are going to have the strongest growth potential. So if you need help, you can always turn to Vistex, because beyond our wide array of software solutions, we have teams of professionals available who can help turn your data into powerful insights, as well as help you refine and streamline your business processes, help you evaluate and gain the most value out of that investment.
And I know, Matt, besides allowing people to go to vistex.com for more information, in October, we're going to have Vistex, our annual user group summit in October. I gotta believe we're going to be have a lot of content about wholesale distribution, profitability, leaving no money on the table. I got to believe it's going to be a great spot for people to go to.
Absolutely. We'll bring in, you know, various customers of Vistex and you know, people from industry. Take deeper dives into a lot of these areas in wholesale distribution and talk a lot more about it. And hopefully we can all learn from each other and grow and be stronger and better.
And now it'll all add up, won't it, Matt?
Absolutely.
Matt, thanks so much for your time. Appreciate it. Stay safe and stay healthy.
All right. Thank you, Ron.